Welcome back, everyone. Today we learn about aerobic and anaerobic respiration. First, we will cover on what exactly is aerobic and anaerobic respiration.
Aerobic respiration is defined as the oxidation of glucose in the presence of oxygen to release large amount of energy, producing carbon dioxide and water. Anaerobic respiration is defined as the oxidation of glucose in the absence of oxygen to release small amount of energy.
In yeast, during fermentation, carbon dioxide and ethanol is produced.
In humans, animals and bacteria, lactic acid is produced.
The equation for aerobic respiration is as shown. The equation for anaerobic respiration is as shown. In aerobic respiration, the reactants are glucose and oxygen. In anaerobic respiration, the reactant is only glucose. In aerobic respiration, carbon dioxide and water are produced.
In anaerobic respiration, for yeast, carbon dioxide and ethanol are produced. For humans, animals and bacteria, lactic acid is produced.
When there is an accumulation of lactic acid during exercise, it leads to soreness and fatigue, but it wouldn't cause muscle cramps or muscle tear.
In aerobic respiration, a large amount of energy is released.
In anaerobic respiration, a small amount of energy is released.
Both aerobic and anaerobic respiration are catabolic processes.
In both aerobic and anaerobic respiration, chemical energy is converted to heat energy as there is energy released.
Lastly, in both aerobic and anaerobic respiration, there is an overall loss in mass.
Now, we will compare the similarities and differences between aerobic and anaerobic respiration in humans.
In both processes, energy is released, glucose is used as the substrate, and they are both cellular respiration.
The first difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration is the equation as shown.
Aerobic respiration can only occur in the presence of oxygen.
Whereas for anaerobic respiration, it occurs in the absence of oxygen.
In aerobic respiration, no lactic acid is produced, but carbon dioxide and water is produced.
On the other hand, in anaerobic respiration, lactic acid is produced, but carbon dioxide and water is not produced.
In aerobic respiration, large amount of energy is released.
While in anaerobic respiration, small amount of energy is released.
Lastly, aerobic respiration occurs during normal metabolic rate.
But for anaerobic respiration, it occurs during short period of time when huge amount of energy is needed by muscle cells.
And the energy requirement cannot be met by oxidation of glucose due to oxygen shortage.
Next, we will compare the similarities and differences between anaerobic respiration in yeast and anaerobic respiration in humans.
In both processes, glucose is broken down, small amount of energy is released, and they occur in the absence of oxygen.
The first difference between both processes is the equation as shown.
The second difference is the product formed.
In anaerobic respiration in yeast, carbon dioxide and ethanol is produced.
In anaerobic respiration in humans, lactic acid is produced.
Lastly, we will compare the similarities and differences between respiration and photosynthesis.
Both respiration and photosynthesis are metabolic processes.
However, respiration is a catabolic process, whereas photosynthesis is an anabolic process.
Respiration occurs in all living cells, but photosynthesis can only occur in cells that contain chlorophyll.
Respiration takes place in the absence of light, but photosynthesis must take place in the presence of light.
In respiration, glucose and oxygen are the reactants, but in photosynthesis, carbon dioxide and water are the reactants.
In respiration, carbon dioxide and water are the products, but in photosynthesis, glucose and oxygen are the products.
In respiration, there is a loss of mass, but in photosynthesis, there is a gain of mass.
In respiration, chemical energy is converted to heat energy, but in photosynthesis, light energy is converted to chemical energy.
That's all for today. Thank you for the effort to learn with me.
Stay tuned for more interesting lessons.
See you next time.
Bye-bye.